The part of the curses the Israelites under were in a different curses. That's just one of his curses to look like that. That's one of his curses to look like that. You hear me?
Everybody got different curses.
You want to hear your curses?
I know my curses.
What's your curse, baby? That's one too.
I got many of them.
You got many more too. Yeah, right. Well, anyway,
don't finish that. Ain't none of us all pure. You know what I mean?
We're spiritually washing our ass coming out here pushing this word.
Hey, hey, that's
don't worry about my language, man, because I got to speak
to you. What was edited?
Just give me one scripture, though. If you know a lot of them, just give me one, though.
Because we speak English. The only way you can read a real Bible is if you can read Hebrew and Greek.
Okay, so why you not reading the...
Because our people don't speak Hebrew. They don't speak Greek. They speak English.
Say it.
So why you don't read the Jewish book?
The Talmud? That's a Babylonian...
We study the Hebrew Bible. Right. But what I'm saying, though, you got to study the Hebrew. You do that on your own time. When we out here, you can't come out here speaking Hebrew.
Right, because you ain't going to understand the word we say.
Okay.
We don't speak fluent Hebrew anyway.
Okay,
so we got to study.
Have you checked out the book,
Elijah Muhammad.
They say Jacob was a two-headed scientist.
He's saying all this stuff that y'all said that he
said. You ain't supposed to push out bits and pieces. You got to push out the whole truth.
But Elijah Muhammad said the white people are Israelites.
Right.
He teaches the white people in Israelite.
Yes, he does.
He got his books.
Right. It's called The Making of the White Man, and the Life of the Man.
And he said Moses.
You ain't got the book, Richard?
I usually got it. But he said Moses took it.
He was a black man.
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
All of the prophets were black men. Yeah. All the prophets. Right.
I mean,
Lord was a black man.
Look at the History Channel.
He was a black man.
But he told me we gotta be over here because we're the same people.
Yep.
No, he was like a real light color, like brown, like a real light color.
The scriptures say he had woolly hair. Who got woolly hair?
Yeah, he had woolly hair.
Just listen to the scripture. Revelation. Wool, but it was white.
Okay.
It was gray.
I gotcha. And I'm saying that his color is more like the color of sand, like maybe your jacket.
Because he drank wine. And a lot of times when a brother is in heavy prayer, sometimes we get emotional in prayer. We can cry, can't we? You know what I'm saying? And because that redness, because the Lord was always constantly in prayer.
And he's drinking.
Go ahead, you drink that. You know, you gotta drink wine to deal with the spirit.
Hey. You got pamphlets on the
listen,
choir, man.
Listen.
Excuse me, I gotta go. You got pamphlets?
Okay.
Both of my
Twitter.
Come on, man, I gotta go.
Go ahead.
Song of Solomon 105 says,
Don't get caught up in the color, and that's the problem about the world.
It don't matter.
Because the most of the world cannot accept the Lord being a black man. Because they're a bunch of goddamn devils. That's why. You know what I mean?
Take the Lord's name in vain.
When I say the Lord's name?
Hey, I got one for you, though. Look,
His
Song
name
of Solomon.
Is not God. That's a title.
Song of Solomon 105.
Well, I believe in the Trinity.
He's
this is his forefather, Solomon, saying. He says, I am black.
Okay.
That's pretty cut and dry.
He said, yeah, because
that's his curse living that way.
Okay, and what? He said that to him.
The Bible gave us confusion of faith.
No, that was Solomon. No. That was Solomon. But he's a descendant of Solomon, though.
You're going to judge by the Spirit. You're going to judge by the Spirit. Man, listen.
Is that leprosy?
But so anyway, so I was reading Moses about Moses. And it said that he stuck his hand right here, right?
Given to?
I don't know.
The Israelites.
It's the law, right?
Yeah.
So why is there laws of leprosy in the book of Leviticus? Because Israelites got leprosy.
It doesn't go by the
so you going to tell me the Lord gave the law to Edomites now?
No, the law gets to get.
Read the law.
He's an Israelite.
From what tribe?
Hold on. Why are you worried about what tribe, though?
Because
a lot of these times we hear the people are
Judah.
We don't even know.
Because my father and I fought
for him.
Yes, I do know that.
Excuse me. I have a question. In that word that you all are holding, it says that the Edomites are red all over because their blood shows through their skin, and they have covered in hair. His hair is red. He is white.
Let me ask you a question. There's a book in the Bible called the Book of Galatians.
Wait a minute.
No. Who's the Galatians?
Understandable. You're upset.
Who's the Galatians?
Listen.
The Galatians come from the word Celt. Celt. It is.
I'm a new person. I'm trying to learn.
Listen, I'm telling you.
I can walk away.
Are the Galatians even white?
I can walk away. But I'm asking you a question, though.
I don't care about your question.
I'll ask someone who cares. Stop talking.
Here you go. This is Daniel 9 and 7. I want you to speak.
You're not talking to me. Remember?
So what scripture? Now, you're a woman. I'm talking to you.
Don't come to me. And guess what?
Yeah.
I'm a child of God.
Let's stay.
That's an evil spirit.
See, the thing is.
Which one scripture? The one I just gave you. So Esau was on. He was red.
You're talking about Moses.
Yeah, the other one.
Genesis 25.
Okay. So right.
Genesis 25.
And it says he has no repentance. So tell me then, who are the Edomites? How can you convince me that this person right here is an Israelite? I'm not talking to you.
But I'm talking to you.
You don't respect what I'm saying.
I'm the one.
You don't respect it.
I ain't got respect for that.
Let's not get emotional.
You're in an evil spirit. You come in the spirit of the devil.
Stop talking to me.
No. I asked you a question.
No, you don't respect
So are the Galatians Edomites?
Stop.
Are the Galatians Edomites? Yes or no? Are the Galatians Edomites? Yes or no?
Stop talking to me.
Are the Galatians Edomites?
Stop.
So the Lord's coming to save Edomites now.
No, there's no repentance for Edomites.
So, okay.
Let me ask you a question real quick.
There's no repentance.
You know Blake Griffin, right?
No.
That's why I play one way. He's light skinned. His father is very dark skinned.
He
had a white girl. He has sex. So whatever. So it's whatever your father is, right?
She said the Galatians. Well,
hold on. Listen.
Your
dad
was
very dark skinned. Listen.
What's right?
Bro, come on, please. Father's dark skinned. Mother's white. Yeah, okay. Blake Griffin's light skinned.
Yeah.
So he has sex with a white woman. That child is like a straight up white person. Now, is he an Edomite?
No,
because
his father was an Israelite, right?
What's his father?
Go.
Also, was your father black?
Black person?
So it's black.
How do we use that?
It goes only three generations.
Come on.
It only goes three generations.
Read the law.
We can't even tell you that how far.
So, wait a minute.
a long way.
Can you help me understand something? Right. If it goes back even further than that,
right,
how do we know the difference?
Can you get the book about Joab, man? 2 Samuel? Was that 1 Samuel talking about Joab?
That's too much for him.
Nah, we gotta just
get
it.
Excuse me, we can have a civilized conversation.
See, now you're being prejudiced.
No, I'm not.
He's prejudiced.
Because I was prejudiced.
No. No, he's not. He said, do not judge people by their appearance. No. He's a racist, but he's not prejudiced. Learn the meaning of words. Read that.
He's prejudiced.
No, he's not. You're not supposed to judge people by their appearance. That's what you need to do.
I can respect what you're saying because you only respect what I'm saying. So, no. Wait. We're going to talk right here. We're going to talk right here.
We're
gonna
never
do it like this.
Yeah.
It has nothing to do with prejudice.
Well, if you don't want to talk, we all
run towards you
back.
No, I'm gonna speak to someone who can respect what I'm saying. So if you don't respect what I'm saying, I'm gonna stop talking.
The Bible
to
said there's no respect to person.
He just told me he didn't respect what I was saying.
I don't respect.
Revelation 7.
Well, I'm sorry, what was it?
Revelation 7.
No, it's Revelation with an X.
Revelation,
without an S. You said Revelation. I'm sorry.
Revelation 7:1.
Read it over and over.
After this, I beheld, and lo, a great multitude, which no man could number, of all the nations and kindreds of people, which are understood.
So the Lord's a liar, right?
Okay, listen.
Please, or we're going to walk.
So y'all can just walk down the street.
We ain't
got to talk to him.
Because I came over and I walked up a great way to
come. Go talk to Nathaniel.
Have some control.
See, listen.
No, because you out of order.
No, I'm not out of order.
Nah, y'all come in very
disrespectful.
Now
it's
confusion starting.
Please,
they
trying to confuse you. Because y'all being evil. Y'all evil. Nah, y'all evil.
Look, you're causing this confusion.
No, you
stop.
The woman ain't supposed
stop.
To be talking in church. What are you talking about?
Stop.
You're
your enemies.
He's correct. He's correct, though.
A woman ain't supposed to be talking.
So if a person begs a question,
and he said, I'm correct.
But if someone provokes you,
no, you provoke me.
You're accountable for
you call me an Edomite.
You're not. I read from, I know that from the Bible. I'm asking you to tell me how you're not. So in reference to what you're saying. So in reference to what you, no, that, go back to the one you just read. I'm going to tell you.
Y'all are evil.
I didn't have an answer to it. Can you go back to it, please, so we can respond to it?
Nah, just read what you
want to
read, bro. Don't listen to that.
Now,
you know, you're the Israelites, right? The Israelites, because we broke the laws and the commandments, he scared us, right? The
Lord said,
blood. So that's what we're doing with this.
Are we going to have an exchange? Are you just, I do
want
to go back to that. I'm asking you, I want to respond to that and then go to that.
He's an Edomite. He's an Edomite, though.
Go back to the one you read.
What church are you? You said that Galatians were Edomites. That's evil.
Why can't we go back to
your evil?
Read it
okay,
one more
okay.
Time.
You guys have no reason.
That's why you curse.
So your blood should
you can say no. Like the Ephraim, you they can call him no. A king, not turn. We can tell the characteristics of Ephraim.
Wow.
You understand what I'm saying? Yes. You are an enemy.
And then after you get a second, I need you to go back and read that so I can respond.
And then you can tell him, bro.
Can we do that? Is that an agreement?
Our spirit calls.
This is getting mine. To us, confusion.
So that, some brothers, you can't judge people by the color of skin. You gotta judge the spirit.
We're not.
I know you're not. See, that's why you don't know nothing. Because you.
I do know a lot.
You're just going off the skin.
No, I'm not going off the skin.
Just going off the skin.
I can look at Ephraim and tell who's Ephraim.
I just feel like y'all are not letting me speak.
Romans.
I mean, it's so crazy. I just said to you. No, we just had an agreement. You said if you explain that, then it's right.
talking about?
That's an Edomite. That's an Edomite. Go ahead. And that is your brother. That's right. An Edomite. Yo, that's your brother. All talking about. All Edomites. Yeah, the real one come out here Saturday. Don't talk to that detective. A detective. Really? You're an Edomite. That's scared to talk to us. We talking about. That's why they run from us. That's why they run from us. I'm talking about IUIC. IUIC runs from us.
That's why IUIC, Nathaniel, hold up. Nathaniel is a detective. Nathaniel is a detective.
I can't shave it, but I can't grow a beard. And my hair's not bald, it's short.
You feel stupid, I bet.
My hair's short.
Why ain't you wearing a dress? Why aren't you wearing a dress? You wearing men's clothes. You wear men's clothes. You wear men's clothes.
And I came up here to get information.
Then don't try to judge. Let's not be judged.
And you're an Edomite. Period. You cause all this destruction. Instead of people coming over here to learn, he has pushed people away. That's what they do. That's what they do.
Hey, 1 Peter 2:11 Let the woman learn in silence.
Let the woman learn in silence.
With all subjection. But I suffer not a woman to teach. Nor to usurp authority over the man. But to be in silence.
You're an animal. And your father is not blessed. Your father is not a Judean. Period.
Believe what you want. We don't care. Goodbye.
That's your people.
Yeah.
You're not no Israelite. You're an Edomite.
Thank you.
That was beautiful for, because the camera showed how women bring their confusion, man. That's beautiful, man.
Because look, we, when a woman's acting like that, though, you ain't supposed to be respecting like that. Talking about respect me. I already knew they wasn't going to let you say nothing because they already knew everything. And they following Nathaniel 7, who's a detective for the NYPD.
Let's come out on Saturday and get a real lesson.
motherfuckers probably running shit.
Why she out here now then? She already got the three on the stand.
They call me the devil, but they call Nathaniel 7, who's a detective who works for the devil. Go figure that one out.
Sound like a group of hyenas, man. That was crazy.
Hey, I eat them, I go.
And we was in the kingdom, we was just... In the kingdom of heaven, we was just... Back in the ancient world.
Bend over.
Back in the
ancient world. Oh, and they would have been in order like that. We would put them to death. They would have had that fear of that.
Shit, even right now, they talk that shit now. If I was on Facebook or something, hit them a private message, she'd be at my house tonight. You know what I'm saying? Like, hey, what's up, baby? You know what I'm saying? I got some liquor. You know what I'm saying? They talk that shit, bro. And they know something. Like, it's going to hurt my feelings or something. That was funny too, how all the people at the bus stop was on our side. Because they know how we do it, bro. They know how we do it out here. They know we ain't.
They sure were working.
They was trying to get everybody to turn on us. They want to have it.
One walk by is like, y'all continue doing what y'all doing.
Yeah. They know we mean business out here, bro. This ain't no game. Think they gonna intimidate somebody.
This is Joe.
You see Jake do that before too. You the devil try to get somebody to turn against you.
That was
on, bro.
That was wrong. That's her technique. Her technique failed her. It failed her, man. That's what it was. She was supposed to have 2/3 niggas to come up against us. You know what I mean? It didn't work.
And we was due for one of the Edomite things, you know?
It was due for the black one.
Hey, she said the Galatians were Edomites.
Sure did, sure did. So they chose the soldiers.
She said the Galatians are Edomites.
She said the Lord came to the Galatians, to the Edomites. That's what she said.
Because the word Galatian, if y'all don't know, come from the, that's where you get the word Celt. The word Galatian means Celt. The Celtics, that was the church of the Celtics, who were all Jakes. All the Irish and Israelites.
Well,
okay.
Yeah. Black woman, that's her power leaving her, man. Her power's slipping. Her power's leaving, man. She's losing her power in Esau's world, man. You know? And part of Esau's technique was to keep the family separated by destroying this woman's mind.
That really was that was awful, man. Because you know how that's how they be acting in the street.
Yep. That's a prime example of Esau losing his power when that black woman, there's no one backing her up. That's mine. I take claim. Take mad claim right there, boy. That's mine right there. This is Job 39:17. Because the Most High hath deprived her of wisdom, neither hath he imparted to her understanding.
And that's proof, too, that she got no understanding because they learned her from Iuic.
Yeah, we was giving her real good, clear scriptures. What was she saying?
She's talking about divide. She was trying to divide us.
She tried her best.
You know what I mean? Like, y'all gonna turn on me.
Stop talking to me. I'm talking to them.
They don't know nothing about what real brothers is.
Old school Luke Cage. That's old school Luke
Cage. Yeah, he gonna knock somebody out, boy. Like,
got that chain. We out here every Monday to rap with the brothers, the Israelites.
We got videos on YouTube.
Israelites, you know? YouTube channels.
Well, you can find links to all the videos on Kings of the Earth on Twitter. That's some, that's well, some code word. Well, I mean,
every nation lasts 200 years,
and then it
just...
Collapses. Yeah, it's on its way out.
I mean...
Yep. You can see it, can't you?
Yeah, I can see it. Because they're trying to put a president like this in here.
Right.
Here's a guy who's a braggart. He doesn't drink.
Oh, that's
his father, died from alcohol, so he never
drank liquor. I think he does.
But he's a misfit.
Yeah.
What's a king of the earth, too, right?
Yeah,
king of the earth. And he's had a relationship. He had three wives, a bunch of girlfriends, children by this woman, that woman, that woman. And that's the president.
And he claimed he a Christian, too.
And his wife was a stripper,
Looked like a
go-go, exotic dancer.
Right. Yeah,
and that's the first lady.
Let me show you pictures of his wife.
She looked like a harlot, don't she?
Let me show you pictures of his wife.
She got naked pictures.
That just tells you what the treatment they can have if they vote for him.
Yep.
They get
better. I know
what's her name? Malaya.
Hey, see a whole number of three of
Yeah.
All right,
brother. Yep.
All right, sir.
times you seen that though? How you gonna talk to me and then don't speak? That's why I'm saying is because when, because you can see that spirit, Susie. You already know you can't teach her nothing. She can't be taught. Unless it was Nathaniel himself or one of his goons, they ain't going to listen.
Oh, they taking that Genesis 25, man, for what it is. They running.
But I asked him the question, too. I, as soon as the big fat one came up looking like the black large Marge, she looked like a semi-truck driver.
Right.
You know what I'm saying?
Right, right.
Looked like she drives a semi-truck.
Fear belly and all.
Looked like, nah, we drive a dump truck. You know what I mean? She operate motherfucking a bulldozer and shit. You know what I'm saying?
Right. That bitch was a thing.
The first thing she came up, she got cut as soon as she opened her mouth. Oh, yeah, that Leviticus. Because I was like, who was the law given to? Leviticus given to? And she said it. She said Israel. I was like, so it was given to Esau, right? She's like, no. She said it wasn't given to Esau.
But she said it in Galatians.
So why is there laws in the book of Leviticus on leprosy? That's for the Edomites? I don't think so.
This is Psalms 147:19. He showeth his word unto Jacob.
Unto Jacob, not Esau. Because she's pretty much making it seem like Esau would be saved.
Yeah. His statutes and his judgments unto Israel.
Under Israel, the statutes and judgments, which is written in the book of Leviticus, Deuteronomy, Numbers, that was given to Israel. One given to no Edomites. Go ahead.
He had not dealt so with any nation.
He didn't give them laws to Esau. He gave it to Israel.
And as for his judgment, they have not known them, praise you.
And now we're going to read one of them laws, and one of the statutes is written in the law. The book, the word Leviticus comes from the word Levi. It's the tribe of Levi, the ministers of the law. That's where the modern day word law comes from, a lawyer. That goes back to the Hebrew word lawyer, which is Levi, the tribe of Levi. Because now you got these devils in the courtrooms, they call themselves lawyers, but they get that from the Bible. But they're not upholding the laws of the Bible. Because the laws of the Bible said to convict somebody of murder, you got to have at least two witnesses. They'll convict your ass with a piece of hair. You know what I mean? Under a microscope, that was their witness. They were constantly locking people up in the jail for years and years, wrongfully in prison. Go ahead, let's read that scripture in Leviticus.
Leviticus 13:12.
Sorry, 12. Yeah.
If a leprosy break out and rise on the skin.
Yeah, this is leprosy. It's like the Bible reveals all mysteries. It tells you where all the different color skin people, the different colors of skin comes from. And this is telling you the origin of the white-skinned Israelites. Go ahead. Because originally all the people were dark-skinned people. Israel was all dark-skinned originally. The one they called Jesus Christ was a black man. Okay, Moses was a so-called black man. All the prophets. Go ahead.
Leprosy covered all the skin of him, and had the flag of his head, even to his foot. Then the priest shall consider and behold, the leprosy was covered all his skin.
He's all turned white, he's clean. That's talking about when somebody catch a leprosy, and the skin changes color. You know what I'm saying? And that was a law given to the nation of Israel and nobody else. I think there's more than that.
Let me get to this, man. Since she mentioned the book of Galatians.
Yeah, because like, yeah, that. Because you got a lot of people say the only Israel, only black people are Israelites. We know that's not true, because like you got the book in the Bible called Galatians. The word Galatian, that's where you get the Gauls. The Gauls is another way of saying Celts, okay? So you could really call the book of Galatians the book of the Celts, the Galatians, the Celts.
Paul. Not of men, neither by man, but by Yahweh Shai, the Father, who raised him from the grave, and all the brethren which are with me unto the churches of Galatia. Church. Mentioned brethren.
He said it's his brethren. So you gonna tell me Paul and that big fat demon that was up here, that dump truck driver, She said, I asked her the Galatians were Edomites, and she said yes. I think she said it more than once. She kept saying, she said, yeah, they're Edomites. But Paul said that was his brethren.
Grace be to you and peace from the Most
High. Oh,
he
said grace be unto Esau.
Right.
Right? People sound stupid when they speak.
And our Lord Yahweh Shah, who gave himself for our sins.
For our sins. God, there goes that our. For whose sins? Israel's sins.
That's right.
All these people Paul was teaching was all Israelites. Regardless of what they was looking at.
Edomites in here.
No, ain't no Edomites up in there. Only time you're going to see Esau in there is when he's getting destroyed. You know what I'm saying?
Gave himself for our sins that he might deliver us from the present evil world, according to the will of the Most High and our Father, to whom be glory forever and ever. Amen. I marvel that ye are so soon removed from him that called you into the grace of Mashiach unto another gospel, which is not another, but there be some that trouble you and would pervert the gospel of the anointing.
Hey, your girls came up here and they was troubling the hell out of us, wasn't it? And they was perverting the gospel, didn't they? They perverted the hell out of the gospel. Paul, he read the scripture too, they wouldn't even hear it. Because there can't nobody get around that scripture in Revelation. In the book of Revelation, it said what? That there was a great, in the kingdom of heaven, there was a great multitude of people of all kindreds.
You see,
nations.
Why you are, that's how their truth, they're, whatever the bullshit they teaching is limited like a motherfucker. Because they can't go into these curses, man.
They can't.
Because if you go into the curse, you gotta bring it out correct.
And there's a lot of scriptures they can't read, and they avoid it all costs. They avoid. They are not gonna read that Revelation 7.
Right.
They're not gonna read it
right. Because
you know people will see right through that bullshit.
But though we were in danger from heaven, preach any other gospel unto you.
I know I'm not the only one that smells that.
Oh man, they do that every day.
What's the weed?
I don't know where it's coming from.
That's dank, right?
Oh, they always smoke.
They're coming from two-third lights. That's what they're called, two-third
lights. They stay smoking out here.
That's a new tribe that the Lord is going to be. You're going to have pleasure in this show.
Two-thirds.
That's what it's called, two-third lights. Two-third lights.
Two-thirds of our people are going to be destroyed.
Right.
That's up to them.
Well, yeah. You better hope you ain't part of it.
Oh, yeah. My best, you know what I mean?
What's your nationality? You're Puerto Rican. You're Ephraimite. You're an Ephraimite.
You're telling us where you're an Israelite.
Right.
Oh, I try my best.
You're a Jake, you're a brother. Well, you got to continue to wake up.
Because I feel like we just going into that Israel is scattered among all nations. You know what I'm saying? Like, we just got in an argument. Well,
that's the cake unturned.
Yeah, we had
that's a cake unturned.
We had
described you as a cake unturned.
Like, we had
to get light skin. That's a.
Because we had these dumbass hoes just came up here. That's what else could I call them? There's no other word I could use to describe you. But they was coming up here, you know, saying only black people are Israelites, they was calling me the devil, you know what I mean? Because they don't know the truth, because the Israel was scattered among all nations.
Scattered.
That's what we just talked about.
Yeah, that is some shit some dumbass hoes would say.
Dumbass hoes. Try to explain it to them, man. That Daniel 9, that's a beautiful scripture, because it tells you confusion of faces.
And you read that next week.
It just went over your head.
Right over there?
Over your head.
You know,
you're trying to impress with me. I mean, no, really, I feel you cussing about this and that, man. And that's just a little, the Lord is rejecting.
Right.
That's just a, that's it. That's it. Because really, the Lord's going to kill a lot of these nigger women. He's going to kill, man, a lot of them nigger women that's going to make it is going to be young. You know?
Yeah.
They're going to be young, man. A lot of them older folks ain't going to make it. They out of here, man. It's going to be my pleasure to chop a few heads off, too.
Hey, the Lord said it, when the Lord, he's going to give us power.
Yeah, that's right. Power, spiritual power.
Right now, we ain't got no power. Only power we got is reading scripture.
That's it.
Right, the Lord giving us the power.
That black bitch got 911. She got that spiritual button called 911. You know, and she got that camera on the phone. That's him.
If there wasn't no 911, there'd be no women's rights. There'd be no baby's daddies.
Right, right.
You know what I'm saying?
That shit's about to go.
It's all about to go.
All of this is about to go, man. All her liberty is about to be thrown out the window.
Because a man's supposed to be running shit, not a woman. A woman, come on, bro. That's why your day's so fucked up. You got women running shit, high positions of power, telling them they can do what they want, leave their man, break up the family. But it's all by design, though. Like you said, these devils that own the banks and everything, they the same people who pass these laws to make it so, a man can't even have a family no more. because they encourage adultery. They encourage through all the TV shows, all the music, you know, listen to the Beyonce.
Yeah, that makes a lot of sense.
It's all by design, you know what I mean?
That's what the Lord bringing. This is the Lord doing this.
Yeah, it really is.
It's the Lord doing it. He's going to see once he's separating everything. He's bringing in the kingdom of heaven. That's why. He's going to destroy this world. So he's bringing it all out, you know, so he can destroy this world. He made this world a great nation just to destroy it. And within that great nation, it's all filth and abomination and rivers.
Yeah, look at that. Yeah, because that's how they do it, man. Because of a man's power, he goes in his family. If you ain't got your family, you ain't really got shit. You know what I'm saying?
Suppose ye that I come to give peace on earth, I tell you, nay, rather division.
Oh, what you read? What you read?
Yeah, because you see nothing but division out here, especially with this Trump thing. The country's like divided right down the line against each other.
That's right. It's always been divided.
Yeah, it's really getting even more divided now.
You know what red letter is in the Bible? That's the Lord himself speaking. Red letter. And that's red letter that he read, that he towards bringing division, you know?
And
this place is about to burn. Seriously, it's about to literally burn. And the missiles that Russia, China, North Korea, the European Union will send over here, they all gonna shoot missiles on America. And there's a lot of Russia alone have all the missiles enough.
Yep.
But the missiles gonna come from everywhere, man. And the earth is, the scriptures tell you the earth is gonna rock to and fro like a drunkard.
Yep.
That's how many missiles gonna be hitting this bitch. You know what I mean? But I got...
At the end of the day, that's what you call it, the end game?
The end game. We'll get the end game,
That's the cherry on top right there, though. That's the cherry on top of the missile.
This is Revelation 17:3. So he carried me away into the spirit, into the wilderness, and I saw a woman sit upon a scarlet-colored beast full of names of blasphemy, having 7 heads and 10 horns.
And that's really talking about America and NATO, which is the greatest... Because a beast, you know what a beast is in the Bible? In the Bible, it mentions 4 different beasts. And what a beast is a great military power. In the ancient world, you had the 4 main beasts. The first one was the Babylonians. Then you had what's up, bro? Yeah, you know what I mean, Jake? Tell about the spirit. He from another country, but he got swag. He's about pimping down the street. Yeah, Ethiopia. A lot of our people is in Ethiopia. But in the ancient world, you had these different beasts. Like, you ever watch that movie 300? They show you how the Spartans was fighting the Persians. And you see, when the Persians was walking the army to the ground, it was causing earthquakes. But that's that great beast. And they even called it a beast in that movie. So now the beast now is America and NATO. It's the greatest military power in the history of mankind. And that's what that scripture talks about.
And the woman was carried arrayed in purple and scarlet color, and decked with gold and precious stones and pearls, having a golden cup in her hand full of abominations and filthiness of her fornications.
You can see that filth out here, you know what I'm saying? All this blasphemy they be pushing out here.
All the philosophies. America just breeding different philosophies. Niggas just wake up and inventing this shit. You know what I mean? Look. Louis Nigga Farrakhan, you know who Louis Farrakhan is? Was the head of the Nation of Islam, the black Muslims. This motherfucker teaches Scientology.
Yeah, that's the shit John Travolta and Tom Cruise is into.
So he's pushing Islam and Scientology. Right, what's your brother, what's that move to do, who started Scientology?
L. Ron Hubbard.
Right.
L. Ron Hubbard was a student of Aleister Crowley. You know what they call him, the wickedest man of
all. Oh, that's crazy, man. And that's the starter of Scientology.
You know what, they got a Scientology church
right now. The progenitor of Scientology was a Satanist.
Yeah.
The progenitor of Scientology was a Satanist.
Because our people, man, that's one thing our people love to follow, everything but what they're supposed to follow.
Yep.
You know what I mean? They want to call themselves an Egyptian, a Buddhist, a Hindu. And they'll take any path except for that right path. You know what I mean? They don't want to walk down that straight path.
That's right. And upon her forehead was a name written, Mystery Babylon.
Yeah, Babylon. You know, Babylon is a Hebrew word. It means confusion. That's where you get the word Babylon. Like them hoes came up here, Babylon. You know what I mean? That's why this is called great. You ever hear, you know, the reggae singers, they call America Babylon. You know what I mean? Because America is Babylon. It's the land of great confusion. Don't nobody know who their dad is. Don't nobody know if that's a man or if that's a woman.
You got children. You don't know what the fucking children is for.
Yeah, you don't even know your children.
That shit bothers me. I don't want them. Like, okay, today this happened. There's a lady right there. I was like, hey, ma'am, you registered to vote? He said,
yeah, I am.
What?
Muscular hands. What it says, the golden cup in her hand full of abominations and filthiness.
That's
of
that part of that filthiness right there. Yep.
Hey, what's up, man?
if you say,
that girl like dick.
Right.
You know what you should say?
Vegemite.
You need to go skim a donut to promise all these people. You didn't tell me what's on it. Now he's sweetie.
All right, bro.
Any man play right, about girl you talking about, man.
My
bro.
Man.
They be on that K2.
Yeah.
Oh, that K2 ain't no joke.
What's that?
K2?
What's K2?
Isn't that what he said?
Is that some drugs or something?
Yeah, it's a drug. It's
That's right.
It's like the incense,
fake.
And I've had friends go to the hospital.
That's part of that filthiness right here.
Right. And upon her forehead was a name, Mystery Babylon the Great, the mother of harlots and abominations of the earth.
You can see that this place is the mother of all abominations on the earth.
Yeah, that's a real treat today. Oh, shit.
Yeah, we ain't had one of those in a
while. That's a real gift today, man.
I got called an Edomite.
Yeah.
What
they say about us for supporting you? We got to answer for what you say. We do.
That's a funny shit.
Yeah, right. That was a great division. What they call it? There's a name for that, man. It's a division tactic they use. Because Polite used it when he was getting.
Yeah, I know they try to get.
What's the fuck is that name?
That's the same thing that Kevin do that one day. He was trying to get people to come against him.
It's an actual name of it. It's called, it has a name to it.
I know what you're saying. That Latin term, right? I can't think right now.
Fuck it. Division's good enough. Division's good enough.
Oh, bro, I mean, it's happening right now.
You know what I mean? Like the news.
We pray it happens now. I mean, we don't know.
Yeah,
the scriptures in Matthew 24 say no man knows the day or hour. Yeah. He said,
we can see it coming.
The one they call Jesus. In Hebrew, his name is Yahweh Shai, not Jesus. You should remember that name, Yahweh Shai.
We see it coming, though. You see that storm. Before it rains, you see the storm come, before it comes.
Yeah.
You know, and that's that storm that's going to come. The Lord gives you clues in that time. And right now, is there more clues to what's going on now? With the division, politically, what's going on in the world, economically, what's going on in the world, America over there in the Middle East, over in Ukraine, they're over in Syria. They're in Africa, you know, provoking the war.
You're supposed to be praying constantly that it happens today.
Oh, sugar
today,
to come again.
We're supposed to be constantly praying that it happens today.
Oh,
you
sugar
know
to
what
come
what
here.
This bitch comes. This is Matthew 24.
Man, watch, they might have some menu or something.
Yeah.
Watch him though, keep an eye on him. Don't even look at him. Dude, get turned to stone, bro. Like Medusa.
He's saying
turn to stone. Well, you know what? We already that stone. We under right millstone, so yeah.
Oh yeah.
We already that stone. We grinding their philosophy, their bullshit. We grinding and they just like, why they got them out of here. They gonna wake up tomorrow, man, hurt their, they already got herpes and all kind of shit, man. Most
come on,
gonna
bro.
Break them out, man.
Don't you know? Just let me read the scripture. We ain't getting into that. We can get on the CDC and look up the statistics.
Hey, we don't want to bring up the sign we got.
Oh, shit.
You gotta
go ahead and bring that up. No, just read that. Why I get the sign?
Man, we out here to teach the people, man, and enlighten the people to the world. And this is just what we do, man. This is that water, that living water, man. That's why we still born and they run. You know?
I don't know. Do we still got that?
Matthew 24 and... 32. Now learn a parable of the fig tree. When the branch is yet tender, put it forth leaves, you know that summer is not. So likewise, you shall see all these things, know that it is there, even at the door.
And all those things he mentioned before then was all the signs of pestilences, diseases. Right now, they got uncurable.
Right here.
They got uncurable gonorrhea.
Oh, they got uncurable
syphilis. that you can't even, you can't even imagine waking up and your dick is burning. You know what I mean? Like, you want to run to the clinic. You know what I mean?
But look, this is from 2008 numbers. So I got to get an updated one. But according to the CDC, the Center of Disease and Control, what does it say, 110 million Americans?
There's only 300 people in America.
300 million, right? But over 110 million got some kind of form of STDs.
That's the CDC. That's realistic.
Herpes, dude, and herpes even like people. If you have chicken, if you have a cold sore, that's a form of herpes.
Yeah.
So that when I say that, how do you even know how a cold sore when it's really
The devil gave it to you when you was a baby because he gave you a shot. He gave you this when you came out the womb. So the devil owns you. He can do what the fuck he want to do to you because he owns you.
Chicken pox, that's a form of herpes.
Stop, baby. So, I dare you to go to the devil and be like, you gave my baby a shot of what?
On your STD policy.
Protect that doctor before they protect you.
Information.
That doctor's doing the devil's job.
Chicken pox is not an STD.
That's why he's called a doctor, a deceiver, an adult.
So, cold sores.
I think that's like 8%.
This is how they categorize it. So, yeah, that sounds right. It's like, you know, anybody with a cold sore has
that shit lays dormant, too. You can have one.
You're in exams.
It could go away.
So, it does. Hepatitis C. You know what I mean? People that, like, got blood transfusions before 1985 or something. You know what I mean?
AIDS all up in this shit.
Right. And I mean, shit like that. I mean, it's still counted as having an STD.
They got homosexuals giving up plasma, going to the plasma, right? All over.
Yes, I know, but it's not only homosexuals have.
They do have the highest percentage.
I'm just saying, medical.
No. Yes, I am totally down with that. Yeah. With that idea.
There was also talking about
that.
But I'm just saying, yeah. You know what I mean? I'm just trying to make him think you guys aren't full shit by saying that. I know you guys are right by saying it.
It's the Medical Association of America that runs blood units, these blood buildings that you go and donate blood.
I just switched off my phone, so what church is this?
This is church.
You guys are pretty deaf.
Well, that's all right, though, because see all the people that see.
We was talking to you.
See all the people that see.
I know.
See all the people that see.
That was a joke. Anyway, but I sing. I sing in a choir, and your choir is...
Gonna sing as a hymn? We sing it right now. We sing it as a hymn,
yeah. Our God is an awesome God. He reigns from heaven above with wisdom, power, and love. Our God is an awesome God.
There you go. Okay.
The spirit of
Madonna. Yeah. She might be one of the old actresses. Look at that. They always had the long ass cigarettes. What that was.
I knew you were gonna ask.
He's
that.
Like,
why do
I get a discount?
I work in silence. But when I'm at work, I talk like this. Everyone thinks I'm from London, okay? So if you come in there, you've got to, like, you know, keep it all under wraps, right? But pray for my ankle because my ex-husband beat the crap out of me. He's a piece of shit.
Oh, no, shit.
He ran me over. He hit me with a car. He hit me with a truck.
Damn.
Yeah, he killed me, and they like shocked me back and everything. So.
Holy shit.
And that happened in November, yeah. So anyway, and now I'm getting ready to put a 7-inch heel on.
I'll be there, Sirens. I'll be up there.
Anyway, no, yeah. Listen, so like, if you guys are out here, when I broke some passes and shit, you guys can.
Okay.
You know what I mean? You guys can come in and like.
Right. Sirens,
yeah.
Where Sirens located at?
It's at Cleveland and 270, right past 161.
Oh, the place is lit up with fluorescent.
Shit.
Fluorescent color.
Wow, you're quick.
That's right by the corner store.
Oh, yeah.
That's right there.
Yeah, you can walk there and walk home with your elbow.
Oh, no, I got some
baby. Anyway, just make sure you're well closed, okay? Oh, as much as your heart, soul, and forgot. Anyway, my name is Winter. Okay, sorry. You know.
There's a litter. Littered alert! Littered alert! Litter! Hey, reptilian! Huh?
I thought she was handicapped.
Look, Leonard ignored us. Damn, I just want to go chase Leonard, man. I just want to scare Leonard out. You know if I run at him, he's going to start running, right? Last time I seen him, he said he had beardophobia or something. But he gave me the technical name for it. I was like, come here, bro, give me a hug. And went up. No, he literally started screaming and yelling and ran away from me. He's like, no, get away from me.
It was funny.
I was like, come on, bro, just give me a hug. I'm glad it's here.
We'll get a couple more.
It don't matter. We at the end. Ooh, I got a good scripture to bring out. You got something? Hey, you can read that. That's good.
But that day and hour knoweth no man, know not the angels of heaven, but my Father only.
All right, because that brother was up earlier because he really wanted to know. He's like, when the end coming? He's like, I don't know, man. We know it's close. That's all we know. But you're supposed to be praying every day constantly that the Lord will destroy this place.
And I'm assuming y'all should know that if you tell the motherfuckers when the end comes, they're going to continue to be wicked until last moment.
It's like 1 hour before it happens.
Yep, last moment.
That's why the Lord say he come like a thief in the night. You know what I'm saying? Like when you least expect it.
Now is the time. They already see us out here trying to get them up.
If you want the end to come, you're supposed to be praying for it, man. Yeah. Praying that the Lord destroys this shit and freezes.
Yeah.
And he gonna, you know, bring that fire. Just like the because you know the Israelites, they was praying when they was in captivity under the Pharaoh and that it was, you know what I'm saying?
And they knew the Lord's name.
And the Lord heard their prayers.
Yeah, they didn't teach they didn't know the Lord's name.
Well, then Moses wouldn't have told them the name. If they had forgotten.
They didn't actually teach. They don't know. They didn't know.
That's bullshit.
That's crazy, man.
Then you see.
It's clearly in the scriptures.
You see their fruit he produces.
Yeah, right.
The hagglers that came up here. Hagar the horrible that came up here. That's their shit.
Moses was right. Like, what am I going to tell the people you know?
You don't see no woman that was down with GMS talking like that. They gonna be humble, cool as hell. You know what I mean?
They done caught them a fish.
They gonna salvation. And they gonna go.
She said she was homeless and everything.
Hold up, why?
You can see why her sister was homeless. Shit. And the other one, that I don't know the other thing. I don't know. Maybe that she was an Israelite. She wanna say I'm not an Israelite. You know what I mean? Satan. Damn Satan. Your girl was like, man, that bitch still a stripper, man. Oh my God.
If she was a stripper there, man, and then you know they allow anybody to strip.
Yeah, cause she done seen her day.
She was she was probably wearing that because it's cold out. She did have something on her back. When they strip, they ain't got clothes on anyway. Yeah, I forgot something right off stupid as hell, bro.
I'm in 2nd Chronicles. I'm in the wrong chapter. I'm going to get this Chronicles scripture.
It's too cold. It's too cold. They might still come.
I'm going to hear this prayer for your. Find it. Oh, here it is. This is when I'm just gonna start at 1 Chronicles 29 and 23. But this is, you know, just going into David and Solomon. It's a nice little prayer he threw out there, a speech. It says, then Solomon sat on the throne of the Lord as king instead of David his father and prospered, and all Israel obeyed him. And all the princes and the mighty men and all the sons likewise of King David submitted themselves unto Solomon the king. Just one. Oh, sorry. I'm messing up. That's not what I wanted. Oh, no. Let me back up. 1 Chronicles 29 and 10. My fault. Wherefore, David blessed Yahweh before all the congregation. And David said, blessed be thou, Yahweh Elohiah of Israel, our father forever and ever. Thine, O Yahweh, is the greatness and the power and the glory and the victory and the majesty. For all that is in the heaven and the earth is thine. Thine is the kingdom, O Yahweh, and thou art exalted as head above all. Both riches and honor come of thee, and thou reignest over all, and in thine hand is power and might, and in thine hand is to make great and to give strength unto all. Now therefore, our power, we thank thee and praise thy glorious name. That's a good one though, right? You know what I'm saying, man? What did he say? No, you gotta read that like 20 times in a row. And he said, you know, the Lord is the greatness, the power, and the victory. But we're gonna end it on that. Shalom.